This episode is brought to you by Love Raw Vegan Chocolate.
Hi, and welcome to an edition of Can I Add Boost to Vegetables and Make Something Delicious? I bought a smoker the other day. I'd planned on smoking some vegan cheeses with it, and it kind of works, but not really. The problem is, the amount of chips that this can take just isn't enough to do a cheese, really, because cheeses kind of need hours of time, whereas this gives you like maybe 20 minutes, half an hour. But it gave me the idea of making a mushroom pate, and I'm gonna smoke the mushrooms. Add that with some whiskey, and I think it's going to be a really delicious little smear. I'm not sure if this is right, but for some reason I've got this thought that if I smoke the mushrooms and then start trying to cook them or do much more with it after, the smoke flavour is going to disappear. So I'm thinking I'll probably cook the mushrooms, cook the onions, do everything separately, smoke the mushrooms on their own, and then combine everything once it's more or less ready. And I think that's gonna sort of maximize the smoke retaining properties. We'll find out though, I suppose. I've also just discovered that my food processor is broken. Yay! I'm gonna use my microplane grater, so it's quite fine, although this is the coarse one. I'm gonna start it on a medium-high heat, so I'm on 6 at the moment, it goes up to 9. Just made some olive tapenades and some soda bread. So I think I'm gonna have a really delicious little snack later on. If you ever see microplanes on sale or anything, it's definitely worth the investment. And they're not too expensive. They're a brilliant grater and they never really go dull. You'll see the mushrooms starting to release loads of liquid. I'm adding a little bit of salt and pepper. And that's for flavor, and the salt also helps pull some of the liquid out of the mushrooms. It's got a very minced beef texture, consistency. Maybe microplaning is a great way of doing it. While the mushrooms are cooking down, I'm going to fill up the smoker. I've decided to use mesquite. I think I'm pronouncing that right. Apparently this is quite a punchy, strong flavour wood chip. So I'm thinking that might go quite nicely with the mushrooms. I might be wrong, it might be vile. We'll find out. Once the mushrooms have released a lot of their liquid, so they get to a nice thick, gloopy stage, so you can see it's already quite pate-like in texture, I'm going to sprinkle in some mushroom powder, and this is just dried shiitake mushrooms that I've grated on the fine microplane. And this is really just to boost that mushroom flavour, so if you can't find any dried shiitake mushrooms, don't worry about it. Whenever I cook mushrooms, I like to put in a bit of Henderson's Relish, which is like a vegan Worcester sauce. Sprinkle some of that in. So perhaps half a teaspoon. Well, the mushroom's finished. I'm just gonna set up the smoking box that I built. If you want a deeper explanation of it, check out the potato powder cheese recipe. Transfer them into a little plastic tub. Make sure it fits inside your box. If you don't have a smoker, feel free to pop in a bit of liquid smoke or just skip the smoky part altogether. That's absolutely fine. I'm gonna set the rack on top of the nozzle just so then it's not obstructed in any way. Mushrooms on top. And then as George Michael instructed, let's go outside.
I'll pause here to introduce you to Love Raw, a family-run business that's dedicated to dispelling the myth that vegan chocolate can't be tasty chocolate. From peanut butter cups to their incredible cream-filled wafer bars, Love Raw will have something perfect. Whether you're treating yourself or buying a gift, head over to eatloveraw.com and enter code AUNTIERACHEL to get an additional 10% off your first order.
Onto the onions. Grabbed 4 bay leaves. I'm gonna pop in there. You can use dry, fresh, whichever. Or rosemary would also work well. Thyme would work well. Sage would work well. Any herb would work well, to be fair. Give this thing a whirl, see if it works. I mean, not really. That's 2 red onions, 2 small ones. Oh, they're so strong. Oh. I'm sweating the onions down in the pan. I'm gonna add a little bit of salt and a little pinch of dark brown soft sugar. That's gonna help with some caramelized flavors. These have been cooking for about 5 minutes. I think that's about it, really. They don't taste raw. They've got a nice sweetness to them. It's time for the whiskey. Yay! So I'm gonna pour this in, and that's to partly give it flavor, but it's also gonna deglaze the bottom of the pan. As you can see, it'll lift off any bits. I'm pulling up so much extra flavor. Turn the stove off, but I'm keeping it on here just to keep warming through and burning off some of that whiskey, just so it's not quite as boozy. Pull out the bay leaves. I'm gonna add some butter. Just let the residual heat that's in the pan melt that butter. Stir everything in. Have a go on that. To be fair, even just that smeared on bread would be incredible. And let's go check on the smoker. It's got a really nice smoky, delicious vibe to it. I'm gonna fork through it a little bit, mix it together, because obviously only the top is gonna have that flavor. Have a try of that. For me, that's just enough of the smoke flavor. Transfer this to a bowl. Add the onions. This is 20-25 grams of toasted walnut halves. Give this a good mix through. Have a little try. Oh, it's got quite a sort of grown-up flavor to it. It's not one probably that many kids are gonna like, because it's got lots of intense flavors in there. That's incredible. I'm gonna try it with a couple of barberries. Barberries have got a really nice sour tanginess to them. So this has got the smoky depth of the mushrooms, then there's the sweetness from the onions, and there's also the sort of herbaceous flavor from the bay. So I think maybe the tang will just add another layer of flavor in there. Yeah, that's good. I don't know, heat tablespoon. And work those in. Don't happen to have a bag of barberries, feel free to chuck in maybe some dried cranberries. That would work quite nicely. You do want something that's got a tanginess to it, rather than say a raisin that's just sweetness. But honestly, that bag I've had for about 6 months, so you just use little bits at a time. It does go a long way. I got that from my local Asian supermarket. So I'll let that finish cooling down, although it's only a couple of minutes away, I reckon, really. It's time for my favorite part, the eating, of course. So this is the soda bread that I made. Very easy. Whole wheat flour, bit of plain flour, key ingredient, which is bicarbonate of soda, and that's what gives it the lift. And this has also got some walnuts in it and some caraway seeds. So there's going to be a load of nice complementary flavors in here, I think. All right. All of those flavors in there just work brilliantly together. And the barberries, really glad I had that idea. It's really rich, really sumptuous in flavor, but they're not too heavy, so it's not claggy in your mouth or anything. So it's quite a sort of healthy, relatively healthy smear. You could skip that butter out, then it's gonna be very healthy because there's no other fats in there. But that is just unbelievable. Although the smoking really does give it an extra bit of flavor, you can miss that bit out. It's not crucial. It's still gonna taste very good, but I'm very glad I did it because it's really, honestly, it's delicious. Hit subscribe and tap that bell icon if you wanna see what else I can do to make sure I get my money's worth out of that smoker. Tequila aubergine.